Halo kawan-kawan, kali ini saya bersama seorang teman saya dari Kairo, dari Mesir. Kali ini kita akan bahas sedikit persamaan bahasa antara bahasa sana dan bahasa di Indonesia, tentunya bahasa Arab asli Mesir. Ya, kita pernah dengar bahwa 9 dari 10 bahasa Indonesia adalah bahasa serapan. Dan tahukah kalian bahwa 2.000 sampai 3.000 kata bahasa Indonesia itu diambil dari bahasa Arab? Nah, kali ini saya akan ngobrol-ngobrol sedikit dengan seorang kawan dari Mesir, tepatnya dari Kairo, bernama Hasan. Kita akan bahas sedikit saja tentang kata-kata yang mirip dari bahasa mereka ke bahasa kita. Halo Hasan.
Halo.
Yeah, how are you?
Yeah, I'm good.
Okay, what is your full name, Hasan?
Al Hasan Anas Al Qurashi.
Okay, where are you from exactly?
I'm from Egypt.
Okay.
Cairo.
Yeah. Okay. So now, can you tell me the similarity between our language and your language? Actually, Arab especially.
Okay.
Arabic.
So the basic similarity between Indonesian and Arab languages is that, for example, when you say an object and the adjective of it, you say first the object and then the adjective. It's the same way in Arabic because Arabic is a noun or read from right to left. So for example, you say kursi kecil, we say also in Arabic kursi saghir. So first the object and then the adjective. Also Arabic has a lot of influence on Indonesian because of the cooperation that we had over the last hundreds of years. So for example, we have many words that are shared from Arabic into Indonesian. For example, you have the word sehat or afiat, kuat.
Yeah, yeah.
You have salju, yeah. You have multiple many words. They are also originated from Arabic. Just a little bit of difference between the pronunciation of them, but it's the same word with the same meaning.
Yeah, okay. Okay, jadi kawan-kawan, maksudnya adalah pola bahasa atau susunan kata dari bahasa Indonesia dan Arab itu sama. Jadi kalau kita bilang meja kecil, mejanya dulu baru kecilnya menyusul. Begitu juga dengan bahasa Arab. Dan tentu berbeda dengan bahasa Inggris. Kalau bahasa Inggris itu kata sifatnya dulu baru kata bendanya gitu ya. Oke, kemudian about culture, Hasan, what do you think?
We have also similarities in culture. For example, Indonesian people respect and have good space in their heart for the older people. So for example, when you shake hands with someone, you bow for them.
Yeah, yeah.
In Arabic, we don't really bow, but sometimes we keep our side down. We keep our respect also for older people. We listen to them for advice and so. Also, when you pass in front of people, you sort of hold your hand in front of your body to keep your ego.
Yeah.
From you, the people, we also do the same thing, but with just bowing our head a little bit.
Yeah, yeah.
And we don't walk in a way that's disrespectful. We also, when we talk to people, you say titles before someone. You like, for example, you say Baba or Pa,
that.
Also in Arabic, we keep titles before everyone's name. We don't call them by their bare names out of respect for them.
Yeah, yeah.
So this is also another similarity we have in our cultures. Also, that one of the good things that I like about Indonesia is silatul rahim, that people keep the connections between them, not just between you and your family, but also like the neighborhood and also your city. You know a lot of people and you keep respect for them and you walk smiling. It's also one of the things that is coming from the Arab world, that we have the same similarity. We respect people, we visit them on occasions like in the festivals or in Eid al-Fitr or Eid al-Adha, in Ramadan. We also keep our relations with the people, we keep our smile, we keep our connections always.
Yeah. Oke, okay, jadi dia baru aja jelasin bahwa silaturahmi juga ada di sana, bahkan mungkin Indonesia meniru budaya di sana ya. Silaturahmi is from Arab. Is it Arabic?
Nah, silaturahmi is something from all humans, all religions, but as Muslims, salat rahim, yeah, is from Arabic.
Yeah,
it's
it is
an Arabic,
Arabic
word,
yeah.
And it expresses the meaning of that you keep your connections and relations good
with the people.
With the people, especially your family. Because salat means the connection and rahim means rahmah or mercy.
Oh yeah. Okay. Okay, ya begitu kawan-kawan, obrolan singkat saya dengan Hasan. Nah, hari ini dia bikin masakan spesial buat kami, yaitu what the food that we cook?
We are cooking two dishes. First one is called bram rice, or in Arabic it's called rozd ma'amar from Egypt.
Yeah.
This is a very original Egyptian delicious dish.
Yeah.
And the other one is shakshuka, which is originated first in Yemen, but most of the Arab countries, they have their own versions of it.
Yeah.
Also an egg dish. It's okay. Very delicious as well.
Yeah, okay. It was our conversation. See you, Hasan.
Goodbye.
See you next time. Yeah, bye. Okay.